We are pleased to bring in Hockey Central's Mike Fiuta. Mike, after years of success for the Jackets, this season was a complete dud. But what stopped working for Tortorella in Columbus?
Eric, I think sometimes with coaches like Torts, there's a certain shelf life they have. He's obviously a tremendously successful coach. He's won a Stanley Cup. But you can kind of feel it a little bit, you know, the conflict that was kind of going on with Liney. I mean, an excellent player, you know, previously with Dubois. And I don't know the behind the scenes things, obviously. But when you've got stars players like that, that kind of just rolls over, it kind of adds up. And I mean, he's the kind of guy, he'll probably take a little time off. He won't be out of work for long. But again, certain coaches have a certain shelf life. And Torts, unfortunately, I mean, you think last year, the success between Toronto in the first round, but that's the way the business is. It's a tough one. I'm sure he'll land on his feet.
You talk about the past. We know about the pedigree. You mentioned the future as well. What do you think is next for Torts? You say maybe some time off, but do you think at some point there's going to be interest from other teams, maybe even, say, in Arizona, which currently has an opening?
It depends what flavor they're looking for and where they're at in the build. Like, for me, Torts isn't a guy that just, like, he can coach all levels. He can coach a building team. He can coach a team on the cusp. Like, there's certain coaches that I would look like a Daryl Sutter or a Mike Babcock, so to speak. They're better when there's a more finished product coming in and taking it to the next level. And there's other coaches that can coach right from the ground up. So if you've got, I mean, that's going to be up to Billy Armstrong. But I mean, Ronnie Francis is going to have a lot of choices too there sitting in Seattle. I'm sure there's going to be some openings. So there's a lot of great coaches' names out there now.